हेलो स्टूडेंट, माई सेल्फ विनोद पनारा एंड टुडे वी डिस्कस सम टॉपिक ऑफ बॉयलर चैप्टर ऑफ बीएमई दैट इज बेसिक मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग. सो इन टुडे लेक्चर वी फर्स्ट स्टार्ट विथ फ्यूजिबल प्लग. नाउ इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय बॉयलर माउंटिंग्स. These are the device which are fitted with boiler for the boiler safety. And in last lecture, we discuss pressure gauge and water level indicator. Now, we discuss with fusible plug. So, this is a diagram of fusible plug. In this diagram, there are gun metal body A and gun metal body B. Inside the gun metal body B, there is a one plug, that is a rectangular plug C. Now in this diagram there are fusible metal. So in diagram there are fusible metal which are at the below side of gun metal body B. So this fusible metal has low melting temperature and it is made from tin or lead. Now, what is function of this fusible plug? So, this fusible plug that is mounted at the top side of furnace. This fusible plug is mounted at the top side of furnace. So, in normal working condition, upper end of fusible metal that is contact with water and lower end of fusible metal that is contact with high temperature gas which is produced in the furnace, because this is mounted on the furnace. So upper end that is covered with water which is present in the boiler, and lower end that is in contact with high temperature gas which is produced due to combustion of fuel. Okay, so due to upper end which is contact with water, this fusible metal maintain a particular temperature and it does not melt. Okay, in normal working condition. Now when water level in the boiler decrease, it means large amount of steam produced. So upper end of fusible metal that is now in contact with steam, and lower end of fusible metal that is contact with high temperature gas. So upper end that is contact with steam and lower end high temperature gas. So at that time this fusible metal which has low melting temperature, that is melt, and due to melting of this plug C that is drop into the combustion chamber, and steam which is present at the upper side in the boiler cell which is transferred into combustion chamber, and it stop or reduce combustion of fuel. So this is about fusible plug. I repeat, when the upper end of fusible metal that is in contact with steam, then it's at that time fusible metal melt and this metal plug that is drop into the combustion chamber, and steam which are present at the upper part of boiler cell that is transferred into combustion chamber, and it reduce or stop combustion of fuel. So this is about fusible plug. Now it is used to protect the boiler against the damage due to overheating caused by low water level in the boiler. Then it is fitted on the firebox crown plate or over the combustion chamber. So this fusible plug that is fitted over the combustion chamber or furnace. Then it consists of two hollow gun metal A and B and one conical plug, conical plug C. Now, in normal working condition, the upper surface of fusible plug is covered with water and lower end of plug is contact with high temperature gas. But when the water level in the boiler that is decreased below the dangerous level, then the fusible plug is uncovered by the water and upper end of fusible plug is contact with steam. So at that time this fusible plug melt and this plug C, which is drop into the combustion chamber, and the steam which is present at the upper side of boiler is transferred into combustion chamber and combustion of fuel reduce or stop. And this fusible plug is made from lead or tin. So this is about fusible plug. Now we discuss blow off cork. So this is diagram of blow off cork. It is also one type of boiler mounting. Now what is function of blow off cork? It is attached at the bottom side of boiler and it periodically remove the water which contain dust particles, sediments, etc. So this water which contain dust particle, etc., this water collect at the bottom side of boiler and it is removed periodically by blow off cork. Okay. Now in this diagram there is a one plug, metallic plug, and inside the plug there is a one plug valve hole. So there is a hole inside the plug, and then in this diagram it consists of yoke, shank, guard, gland, casing. Casing means outer box, etc. So its function is to remove dust particle water from the boiler at particular interval of time. Now in this diagram there is a plug which continuously rotate. So now this blow off cork that is attached with the boiler at the bottom side, so this plug is continuously rotate at a particular speed. Now when rectangular hole, this rectangular hole that is throughout, this plug hole that is throughout hole, so when this hole is in front of boiler, then water which contain dust sediments is removed from the boiler. And when this hole that is not in front of boiler, this water which contain dust sediments does not remove from the boiler. So this plug is continuously rotated. So when hole that is in front of boiler, dust particle water remove from the boiler, and when hole is not in front of boiler, this dust particle water does not remove from the boiler. So dust particle water which is present at the bottom side of boiler that is removed from the boiler at regular interval of time, that is function of blow off cork. So it discharge periodically a portion of water which contain mud, scale, sediments from the boiler. It is also used to empty the boiler when necessary for the cleaning, inspection and repair. Then it is fitted on the boiler cell directly at the lowest part of the water space. It consists of gunmetal conical plug having a rectangular hole spindle with yoke. Then when rectangular hole of plug is in front of the boiler, then water which present at the bottom side of boiler which contain dust particle which remove from the boiler. And when the solid portion of plug is in front of the casing hole, the water cannot remove from the boiler. So this is function of blow off cork. It remove water which contain dust particles, sediments, etc. from the boiler at regular interval of time. Okay. Now we discuss feed check valve. This is diagram of feed check valve. So what is function of feed check valve? It controls the amount of water supply to the boiler. It controls the amount of water supply to the boiler. So that is function of feed check valve. Now in this diagram, it consists of non-return valve, then spindle, then gland and inlet pipe and outlet pipe, etc. So water which is enter from the inlet pipe and water that is transferred to the boiler from the outlet pipe. Now water enter into this feed check valve due to pressure difference. Which pressure difference? At inlet of pipe there is a pump pressure and at the outlet of pipe there is a boiler pressure. So due to this pressure difference, water enter by inlet pipe to the feed check valve and there is a non-return valve which control the amount of water that is supply to the boiler, and it is also a non-return valve. So water that is transferred in a particular direction only, not return. And due to this pressure difference, non-return valve lift and allow the water which is supplied to the boiler. And how much this non-return valve lift, that is depend on position of spindle. And position of spindle, that is controlled by hand wheel. So it controls the supply of water to the boiler. It is fitted in the water space of the boiler just below the normal level of water. Then it consists of non-return valve, water inlet pipe, outlet pipe, spindle, gland and hand wheel. Inlet and outlet pipe of valve expose different pressure. This pressure difference lift the non-return valve. Due to this pressure difference, non-return valve lift and allow water flow into the boiler. Now the lift of valve is controlled by the moving the spindle up and down with the help of hand wheel. So flow of water control. So this is about feed check valve which controls the amount of water supply to the boiler. Now next one, that is safety valve. Now what is function of safety valve? We know that it is a one type of boiler mounting and it is attached at the top side of boiler, and when the amount of steam that is produced inside the boiler is greater than a particular limit, then the safety valve automatically open and it remove the extra amount of steam from the boiler, so it protect the boiler. So that is function of safety valve, and this is about spring loaded safety valve, which consists of, in this diagram, it consists of spring, and at the upper side of safety valve there is a lever. Okay, and this lever that is attached with spring. At the center of this safety valve there is a spring. Now this safety valve that is attached at the top side of boiler, so steam which is produced in the boiler that is transferred at the upper side and it is contact with the two end of lever. Now when this steam pressure is less than spring force, then lever is in normal position. Okay, but when the steam pressure is greater than this spring force, then this lever lift. Due to high steam pressure, lever lift, and the extra amount of steam that is transferred into the atmosphere, and in normal level this lever again transfer to its original position by spring action. So this is about spring loaded safety valve. Okay, So it consists of cast iron body having two branch, these two branch, and a lever is placed on the valve by means of two pivots. Then in normal working condition, the downward force due to spring, or it is called spring force, is greater than upward force, and upward force it is due to steam. So spring force is greater than steam force. So the valve is closed due to spring force and there is a no movement of lever. But when the steam pressure is greater than normal limit, it means upward force due to steam is higher than spring force, then lever, that is lift, and extra amount of steam that is released into atmosphere, and again at normal position this lever again transfer to its original position, and that is spring loaded safety valve. Okay, now we discuss steam stop valve. So this is diagram of steam stop valve. It control amount of steam supplied to a particular application. Now in this diagram there is a one valve seat, and there is an inlet pipe from which steam enter, outlet pipe from which steam is exit, then flange, then there is a spindle, then gland, yoke and hand wheel. So the function of feed check valve, it controls the amount of water to the boiler, and steam stop valve, it controls the amount of steam supplied to a particular application. Okay. Now, by the movement of hand wheel, this valve seat that is transferred up and down, so it produces some space in the inlet pipe, and so that steam that is transferred from inlet pipe to the outlet pipe and to the particular application. So we control the movement of valve seat by hand wheel. Okay. So it regulates the flow of steam from the boiler to steam pipe. Then it is fitted to the boiler at the highest part of steam space. It means it is fitted at the top part of boiler. Then the spindle is rotated by help of hand wheel, and due to rotation of spindle, the valve move up and down. When the valve seat is at their bottom position, then the passage of steam is completely closed, so there is a no transfer of steam from boiler to a particular application when there is a close. But the steam passage may be partially or fully open by moving the valve up by rotating the hand wheel. So that amount of steam that is transferred from boiler to a particular application. So this is about steam stop valve, which controls the amount of steam supplied to a particular application. So in this lecture we discuss first fusible plug, then we discuss water level indicator, then feed check valve, then safety valve, and then steam stop valve. All these devices are boiler mountings. So thank you for today's lecture.